Hey there, guys. Welcome back. Tonight I've got another unusual project. It's going to be carving a pipe out of this block of briar wood. Actually, the hard part's already been done for me. I got this kit off of eBay for $10 shipped to my door. Normally you can't find them this cheap, but this one had a little bit of an imperfection, a void space. So hopefully that won't affect it, but the seller made me a good deal, and I figured $10 shipped wasn't too bad. The hard part's already been done, as I said. This stem has already been cut out and fitted with a mouthpiece. And I don't have a lathe yet, so that was something that was a little bit beyond my capabilities with my tools, and the bowl's already been cut out. So why am I carving a pipe? Well, I don't smoke. I don't smoke cigarettes, cigars, pipes, or anything, but I've recently just been intrigued by pipe smoking. The guys at the Moustache and Blade Podcast seem to be pipe guys, and I've always appreciated the craftsmanship of any fine woodworking project, namely pipes. I've always actually appreciated the smell of pipe tobacco. I think it's probably the most appealing out of all. And you know, I kind of look at it as a project to increase my skills. You know, if you come across a project like this if it goes bad, I've lost 10 bucks. But you know, the potential for increasing skills of fine woodworking and the staining and sanding of a good hardwood like this, it could turn out in other avenues, making more shaving brushes or knife handles or anything like that. So anyway, that's what I'm going to be trying to do today. Like I said, I'm not a pipe smoker or a tobacco smoker. I officially don't recommend that you do, but you know what? Hey, I believe in free will of people, so do what you want. But I don't know, when I get this done, maybe I'll give it a shot and hopefully it won't go too bad. So maybe I'll give her one run and then maybe I'll be done, according to my wife. So hold on one second and we'll see what we can get turned out. Okay, so the first step I'm gonna do with this is just give myself some template marks. I wanna make sure the wall around this bowl area is pretty consistent. So I found this piece of 1.5 PVC. I'm just gonna use that as a basic template just so that I can get this thing roughed out. So I'll line this up, give my marks, and once I do that, I'm also going to mark my centers on either side, and I'll actually measure these out too, but just so you can kind of see what I'm going to do. So basically, now I'll start roughing it out and kind of get it to this basic shape, just kind of a cylinder that does a slight curve under, and like I said earlier, hopefully that's not gonna mess it up. We'll be right back.
So now I've kind of got the rough shape, about 80% done. I may make a few tweaks, but it's, you know, basically that's kind of what it's going to be. I need to finish sand it quite a bit more, actually get a smooth surface. But right now, I've still got that crack that, you know, was the thing that made this thing so cheap. So I've read online and I found that people, as long as it's not touching the inside of the bowl, which it is not, people can fill it with JB Weld. So that's what I'm going to do right now. Hopefully I'm not going to ruin this, but basically I'm just going to put that in there, mash it in, and then I'm going to try to rub some shavings into the outside to hopefully blend it in a little bit. So we'll see, we'll put this in, rub it, kind of work it in there, and then I'm going to put these shavings there, and we'll see what it looks like in the morning. And then we'll sand it down. Hopefully it blends in pretty good. I just got it off the buffer, and this is pretty much the final product. I do not have a coat of wax on this to finalize it, but that's just because I didn't have the wax, although that would add a little bit more luster. But man, I'm actually pretty happy with the way it turned out, and you know, very happy with it so far. I'll point out that one little discrepancy, which is what made this project cheap and affordable for me. Was that cavity that we filled with JB Weld. I think it actually filled in pretty nicely. Didn't get there was a couple little areas that didn't fill perfectly, but I think it's gonna, functionally, it's gonna be perfect, or at least adequate. But here it is, guys. I really had a good time doing this. Like I said, you know, you may not be into pipes, but you know, sometimes taking on a project like this, isn't exactly about getting into that, but you know, maybe just increasing your skills for other things. But here it is. I have not tried it out yet, but I'll certainly do so at least once, just to be fair to it. But overall, very happy with the project. I will say thanks again to the guys at the Country Squire Radio for the motivation in doing this project. Anyway, and I really appreciate you guys watching. Hopefully you found it interesting. And if not, you know, maybe a future video will be interesting to you. So as always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.